In the previous video comments, I received some advice about leveling the V wheels. I was planning to recess the spacer for the larger wheels, thinking that would reduce parts. But the smart thing to do, as Kai suggested, was to use two precision shims on the smaller wheels.
And it means I don't need as many large washers on the back. So
I tested this setup on the Y plates I had cut in the previous video, and seeing that this worked, cut the new plates without the recess. So in this version, I've already changed a few things. These include using less V and mini V wheels on the Y plates, centering the anti-backlash nut block, adding space under the X-axis C-beam to install 90 degree brackets, and cutting the larger gantry plate out with a lot less holes than the original.
And hopefully at the end, I will have a machine that I'll be able to share via the open source platform.
I also resized the countersunk heads to accept the flange machine screws, which I'll be using. I'm going to assemble the gantry now, and I'll be using the full set of 12 wheels for this part, although I think I could have got away with 8. I'm using the pillar drill vise to push the eccentric spacers into their holes, and to also hold the plate while installing the parts. The machine screw for this part are 70mm long, but could be smaller if I had been using thinner plates. The spacing starting from the head of the machine screw is either one aluminium or eccentric spacer, depending on which half of the plate you're fitting, followed by one shim, a large V-wheel, two shims, one aluminium spacer, one shim, a large V-wheel, one shim, and finally either one aluminium or eccentric spacer. All those parts are being sandwiched between two 12mm birch ply plates. After assembling everything, I slowly work my way through tightening each of the eccentric spacers from one side to the other. But I think the birch ply is still too soft to hold the machine screws and their wheels perfectly in the holes. And I could see a tiny gap alongside one set of wheels. I've measured the aluminium and eccentric spacers, and they were identical, so I don't think this was the problem, and the precision shim seemed pretty precise. To find out why I have this gap, I could dismantle the pieces. I began thinking whether I should use one plate or space one V-wheel per machine screw on opposite sides on the V-roll extrusion, but I also don't want to unscrew and reassemble these parts too many times, just in case the plate holes wear down further. I think it's likely that the ply is too soft and doesn't hold the machine screws parallel. But there's not much I can do about this, so I might as well carry on. The parts move well despite the gap, and there is no noticeable play. This is just a reminder that I'll have to recut all the plates from more durable material once the machine is completed. I'm going to assemble the Y plates now, and again using the pillar drill vise to make assembling easier.
Okay, I'm going to put the wheels on the Y plate now. I'm just going to make sure that the bearing hole is facing inwards.
I'm using four mini V-wheels and two larger ones for each plate. Four of these are on eccentric spacers, and two are fixed. The fixed wheels rest against the underside of the rail within the C-beam and are opposing the downward movement of the spindle. That is to say, when the spindle plunges, the fixed wheels are less likely to slip or move by the forces pushing upwards. The setup is the same with the larger gantry plates. And again, once everything was assembled, I gently tightened the eccentric spacers against the extrusion and checked the distance between the wheels using the vernier caliper. I think this is going well, especially considering the material I'm making this from. There was a gap along one set of V-wheels on the gantry plate, and while this could cause the Derwent wheels to wear unevenly over time, I am planning to recut all the plates out of more durable material once complete, and this should hopefully correct it. Anyway, I'm going to leave this video where it is, while I wait for a few more things to arrive in the post. In the next video, I will make my own anti-backlash nut blocks using PTFE. Thanks again for watching, sacrificing your thumbs, sharing your comments, and if you've become a patron subscriber since the last video, welcome aboard. The link to that and the other usual things will be on screen now.